Welcome back, everyone. Today I'm going to show you how to set up and create a multi-page PDF to display your pattern designs. I use this to then send out to clients for potential licensing. It's a good way to just create a nice PDF portfolio. I also include my mock-ups and my social media posts in here. And for those of you who don't know me, I'm Mel Armstrong, a full-time illustrator, surface pattern designer, and passionate online educator, here to empower creatives just like you. So before we get started, be sure to hit that subscribe button so you don't miss any new videos I post. Let's get started. So it's super duper easy to set up. I have basically used Artboards for each page in my PDF. If you look down here in the layers panel, you can see, let's just close all these groups. Basically each group is an artboard. So there's my collection here that displays all of the patterns, and then we've got the next one is my main pattern, and then so on. So inside the folders you can have multiple layers, and they will all be contained within that artboard. So for instance, in these pattern ones I have a logo and I have a title and I have the pattern all within that artboard. And I often use this as a way to make sure that my patterns work cohesively together. So it's nice to see them all on the page together, and then I can see if there's anything that needs adjusting. Maybe one of them isn't quite working with the rest of them, and it's just a good way to figure that out and see them all together. So let's jump in and I will show you how to set this up, and then you can also save it as a template so that you can keep using it as often as you like. So the first thing to do is go and create a new document. So go to File, then New. Now I'm going to create mine as an A4, but you can create it any size you like. You just have to make sure this artboard checkbox is checked, and then click Create. And so it's just created the one single artboard for now. Now there's lots of ways to create more artboards. You can either just click it, and you can see here it's got the folder and a blank layout. You could drag it down to the plus sign and that will automatically duplicate that, or you could actually just click it and hold down the option key and drag it. That also duplicates it. And you can also, if you click on it with your move tool, which is V on the keyboard, once you click it you can see the blue outline means you've selected it, but you've got these options here with the plus to create more artboards. So if I click there I can create one to the right, or click on the bottom one then I get one below. If you want to move it to space them out, just click and drag on the little blue outline to modify. If you wanted to change the size of one, you can just click on it and you get the option up here to change it to a specific width and height, or you can just click and drag until you get it to the size that you want. So I'm just going to remove those, and I'm going to begin with my first one here. I'm going to basically set up this collection page here, which is what I like to have at the front of my PDF. So let's go back here. I'm going to call this one collection, and then using the rectangular marquee tool I'm just going to click and drag out, and then go to layer, new fill layer, and then pattern. And you might see here I've actually got a shortcut set up for that as well if you want to make it easier. I use this all the time, so I created the shortcut to make my life a little bit easier. And then you can go and select a pattern. So for this I'm just going to put this deer pattern and just scale it down, and I'm just going to drag that down because I do want to put a title at the top. So I'm going to go ahead and just fill in this page. I generally make the bigger ones for my main patterns and smaller squares, if you can see here, for my blender patterns. Now I like to add my logo, I want a title, and I also have my color palette down here. I've got a few extras on here that I've got turned off. So they were on there as my template. So some pattern collections would have more colors, but this one has a limited amount of colors. And let's create a new one. So I'm going to just duplicate that one. And this time we don't need any of this. So I'm just going to delete all these other layers and just keep one. That's our pattern layer. And I'm just going to expand that out to the full page width. You could also, if you don't have one there already, you can just drag that into the folder. And then I just want to scale that. And my logo, I'm just going to convert that to a smart object, and I'm going to move that down to the bottom. And I do want to add a title, so I'm going to use the rectangular marquee tool, and I'm going to just define an area there. And then once again, I have a shortcut for this to fill a new layer, or you can just go to image, sorry, layer, new fill layer, solid color. And I'm going to make sure I select a color that's in my collection, and that kind of works well on top of that pattern. I also want to make sure that that is aligned to the center. And then I'm going to put some text on top of that. And that's way too big, so let's just reduce that down. And I'm just going to make sure that's in the center. Okay, now that I've got that one set up, I can duplicate that and just fill in the other ones. But before I do that, I want to name the artboard. So I'm going to copy that Winter Wonderland and rename the artboard. And the reason for that is when you export it later on, if you want to export it as just a single file, it will use that name, that artboard title, to append to the file name. So it's very useful to have that in there. So I'm just going to create another one over here, and I'm using my control to copy, and then I'm dragging it across. And then this time I'm going to put a different pattern. And then I am going to create another one down below. So instead of using the plus, which will just create a blank artboard, it's much easier to just duplicate what you've got. And that way you just need to replace the pattern and the title, and it will keep everything else there in the right place. And I just realized I haven't named this one the artboard, so I'm going to just name that. And then I'm just going to copy it. I'm going to place it down here. And this one can be, I'm going to rename the title. Then I've got two more. I'm just going to make two copies there. And if you're a little bit anal like I am and you want to have them all aligned, it doesn't really matter, but sometimes I just like to align them. You can just click and drag them. All right, this one can be snowflakes. And the final one is napkin florals. And I'm just going to rename the artboard, and I might change the background color of the title as it's getting a bit lost. And I just want to make sure I use something from my collection palette. And so I've got all my patterns in there now. I now also want to add another one that will be my mock-up. So I'm going to create another one on top here, and we can put it here. And this is going to be my mock-ups. And we can remove that. We don't need that, and I can remove the pattern. And now I just want to drop in my mock-up, so I'm just going to copy it from over here. Now to export that, all I need to do is go to File, Export, and you've got two options here. You've got Artboards to Files or Artboards to PDF. The Artboard to Files will allow you to save each page individually as a JPEG or say a PNG, which might be useful if you wanted to display some of this on your website. But for this, I'm going to export it as a PDF, and that will export it as one file with all those pages in there. So let's pick that option. You want to select where you want to send it to. You want to give it a file name. And if you were exporting this as individual files, I recommend putting the name of your collection here as the prefix and then maybe a dash. And then what it will do is append each of those artboard names as each of the files. You can also change that to document per artboard. So that would create multiple PDFs, but I'm going to leave it as multi-page documents so that they're all in one PDF. I'm also just going to leave the quality at around 6 or 7 so as it won't be too big if you're sending it out to a client. And then all you need to do is click Run. And that has successfully exported, so we can go and open that up in Adobe Acrobat. And if we just reduce the size a bit, you can now see it has exported as a multi-page PDF, which can be a great way to send to clients. You can also share this by clicking on the share button. You can create a link that you could send a client. So that means that instead of attaching it to your email, they just have the link to open up. That saves clogging up their inbox with attachments, which, you know, can be a bit annoying. I know my inbox does run out of space sometimes, and it's all those pesky attachments, so you don't want to be annoying art directors with those. And that is pretty much it. And the last thing I want to show you is how to save that as a template so that you can keep using that over and over. So basically all you need to do is go to File, Save As, and the default will be Photoshop file, which is a PSD file. But if you just add a T onto the end, that will create a template. So if I save that as a template, you can see here this is the template file. It's got the PSDT file extension. So if I open that up, it will create a brand new document. You can see it says untitled here, so this isn't going to override the template. It's just going to allow you to then go in and swap out the patterns. So I could go in here and I could make this my Halloween collection. So I just need to go and change the patterns, maybe adjust the scale. Then maybe go in here and change these as well. And then obviously we need to go and change the titles as well, and then the mock-up. But you can see how easy that is to now just drop in new patterns and your new titles, and instantly you've got another multi-page PDF that is ready to send out to potential clients. So I hope that was super duper useful. If you have any comments or questions, please do comment below. I love to hear your thoughts. And don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button, because that lets me know that you've been watching, and then also lets you know that I have a new video out, so I don't want you to miss out on those. Alrighty, happy pattern creating. Stay creative. Till next time. See ya.